when I come to these kind of schools and I see all this, I was hoping, smiling, they're beginning to smile now. Initially, you were saying, what's going on here? But now you're beginning to lighten up and smile. That's important for me to see. That's the whole point. This is not some heavy stuff I'm going to hammer down you and say, take it up. You think for yourself. If there are ideas that I've given you, which you find exciting, interesting, that you can relate to, then I'm telling you, adopt those ideas, make them your own, and take them away. Incorporate them within your own system. So if you're a Christian, if the ideas I've given you touch you, make them part of your Christian tradition. Adopt them, take them away, make them part of your own. We are not here selling copyrights. So we are not saying become, because we are pluralists, we don't want you to switch religions. Why should you? Because we say Christianity is a good way, go for it. Find your God in your own way. This is one of the tried and tested pathways. Use it fully. We don't want you to switch. It's like a river that has come down the mountain one side. You can say, oh, river, no, go up and come down on the way. That's what changing religions mean. We say, don't do that. You already have your cultural, historic roots with Christianity. Carry on. Become a better Christian. If there are things that I've said which appeal to you, take them away. Make them your own. We don't even ask for copyrights. They are yours. Take them. At the same time, we do not say that you cannot join us. We are very special people. We don't make any such claim. We're just human beings like you. That's why if you say, no, we must join, we want to join, we can't stop you and say, no, this is a private club. We don't do that either. At the same time, we don't encourage conversion because this creates friction in the name of religion. The moment there are many religions fighting for people, saying, okay, I'm going to convert more of these people and become bigger than this, you lost the spiritual idea. It's not spiritual. It's not truly religious, is it? It's horrible. So the idea of forcing your religion on another is something that we should strongly avoid. Let me finish with a funny story, I think. Now you see this idea, the heart of Hinduism, which I use the word spiritual humanism, that you are essentially the spark of the divine, may sound a bit arrogant. You might think it's arrogant, surely. We are creepy crawlies. Why is he calling us that we are the spark of the God? We don't feel like God. Why is he calling us all that? Spiritual humanism. Let me do a funny story. A five-year-old boy came to the Hinduism class and he was told, my boy, like it or not, believe it or not, your essential nature, not your external in your mind, in your body, and your inner nature, your essential nature, the thing that's sparkling in your eyes is essentially you are that spirit. You are God. Now the five-year-old boy didn't understand the message very well. So he said, oh, in that case, this is good. I should have come here to this class earlier. He's telling me I'm God. Good stuff here. I should have joined the class much earlier. So the boy becomes arrogant, puts his hand in his pocket, goes home in a very arrogant mood, and goes to the kitchen and picks out the most expensive piece of plate mommy keeps for the special visitor, waves it in front of mommy, says, mommy, look, look, and he drops it deliberately. It breaks into 1,000 pieces. Mommy becomes furious. Brown Hindu mommy turns pink. Then she lifts her arm and comes near the boy. And the boy says, stop, mommy, stop. Mommy, do you know who I am? Mommy says, first the cheeky fellow breaks, please ask him, who am I? Who are you? Mommy, like it or not, believe it or not, I am God, says the boy. Now, fortunately, mommy had been to the Hinduism class. She said, my boy, my second question is, who am I? The boy had learned his lines well. Mommy, like it or not, believe it or not, you too are God. Mommy said, good, we are making progress. You are baby God, I am mommy God. The third lesson of Hinduism says that whenever baby God goes around breaking plates, mommy God has to do special worship ceremony of the baby God. The boy was getting worried. He said, what? She has to bring the baby God round, turn him round and smack his bottom without leaving a mark, otherwise social service God will come. Why am I lightening up a serious issue? This idea of spiritual humanism may appear like arrogance. It's not arrogance. You don't think I am special, you think everybody is special. And the terms of engagement we have don't change. So when the baby misbehaves, mommy whacks him gently. So the terms of engagement don't change, and yet we have spiritualized everybody. So there is God in everybody, but you have to be very careful. There are some people you need to keep away from. So this is what spiritual humanism is all about. I hope you have enjoyed the session. Please feel free to be in touch with through your teacher with me. Otherwise, look at HinduAcademy.org website and get lots of clips. Or lots of information, a lot of resources. We're going to give some books to the teacher that it will be in the library, which talks about spiritual humanism, religious pluralism, and all these marvelous ideas that I've been talking about. Thank you very much, everybody. Thank you.
Free e-learning course in Hinduism. To register, please visit www.hindu-academy.com.
Talks on Hinduism. Sponsored by People Care. Encouraging caring for the elderly in their own homes. For more information, please visit peoplecare.com.